what is Epic doing? These guys are insane. I don't understand why you would want to have a mission to go out and become the de facto games platform on PC, and then proceed to do so many anti-consumer practices that you're turning the audience you're trying to build away from you. Everything Epic has been doing ever since they put out this platform, I guess including putting out the platform itself, but I suppose their end goal means that was inevitable, is just pissing off their potential consumer base. And I understand the idea. The idea right now is that they're just trying to strong arm their way into it. They have so much cash to burn that they're just throwing their weight around under the impression that at the end of the day, these people are gonna bitch and complain about it, but more than enough people will just do it anyways. And they'll become so ingrained in the PC platform that even the people who don't like it will have to begrudgingly submit to it anyways. This is just bad optics. Why is Epic so interested in having such terrible public image right now? The optics on everything they're doing is so fucking bad. The latest thing that I heard Epic do is that they bought an anti-cheat company that has basically broken Linux compatibility for Steam, because Steam was working on this Proton program that would allow games to run under Linux, and part of it was this anti-cheat thing that was multi-platform, and I guess Epic just bought it, and Epic has literally zero interest in Linux. Tom Sweeney says something like fucking really derogatory about Linux. I forget the exact quote, but maybe I'll edit it in here if I'm not lazy. They bought this anti-cheat platform, and now they're canceling the Linux development of that, which basically means there's no ability to have anti-cheat functionality into Steam's Proton platform, from what I can understand, from what I've read. It seems like they did this not to just bolster their platform, but just to cut the legs out from another one of Valve's projects. They're being very aggressive right now in fucking Valve. And when you have so many people who love Valve and love Steam, this just means you're actively making people hate you. This is bad optics. They buy the developers of Rocket League and say they're going to pull Rocket League off of Steam, so it's an Epic exclusive going forward. This is terrible fucking optics. It blows my mind. The reason all this is happening, and the reason why Epic will be doing all these things that have terrible optics towards consumers, is because Tim Sweeney has said this battle that he's fighting between himself and Steam is not going to be won by consumers. He doesn't think consumer sentiment matters. He's trying to win over developers, because at the end of the day, they have enough money to throw around to get more developers on board so that they can become the de facto platform through force. If they have all the games, what are you going to do? Buy it for PS4? PC Master Race is not going to settle for 30 frames per second, let me fucking tell you. You guys all know that. They're trying to win by force. They're not trying to build a better product. They're trying to destroy the competition through, I don't want to say crony capitalism, nothing they're doing is illegal, but just scumbag moves. So you're just going to have all these customers eventually, if everything goes their way and Epic becomes a big part of the PC gaming platform, that actively hate you? Why not just use all this fucking money and have feature parity with Steam? Why not? And why not make it easy to port all your information and stuff over from Steam to Epic? It just seems like a better thing to do. If not instead of the predatory business practices that they're doing to court developers, at least in addition, there's no reason to make all your consumers hate you when you have more than enough money to throw around to improve your platform that you're trying to build on top of courting all these developers and getting exclusive deals and cutting out Steam's ability to retaliate. You can do all of these things. I think even if they continue to do everything that they did, if they were at least saying, yeah, the platform's gonna be better, and not just do the typical fucking here's our roadmap that we're probably gonna delay and push back and blah de blah de blah, they should be actively engaging the consumers of their product and be like, yeah, we understand this is bad, we're gonna fix it immediately. We're gonna get a shopping cart immediately. We're gonna get wish lists immediately. We're gonna add user reviews immediately. These are all things that should have been in place when the store fucking launched, right? Because if they're trying to take out Steam, they should at least release something that functions as close to Steam as possible, and then add their additions on top of it. That's how you win on the consumer side. But they don't want to do that. They're interested in courting developers at the expense of consumers. And it's just such a bizarre move. Again, the optics. I'm going to say optics constantly. Maybe that'll be the title of this video. Epic's optics are shit. Maybe not the word shit, because again, can't swear on YouTube anymore, apparently. We're all in baby mode. We're all in PG-13. We get like one fuck on an entire channel, and that's all. I don't know. Epic confuses me. I don't really have a horse in this race because my computer has been in storage for the last month. And my fucking graphics card doesn't work anymore. So if anybody has an old graphics card you want to send me so I can start streaming on IM Games again, hey, hit me up, dude. Epic's just making an enemy out of everybody who would be installing it on their system. Everyone who's running Epic is doing it begrudgingly. And it just seems like a terrible, terrible move. I think that's all I really got for this video. It's kind of short, but we all know how fucked up Epic is. And again, I'm talking strictly from a consumer side. For developers, they're doing the right things, and I think that's where they really think the war's going to be won. And they may be right. A year from now, we'll see how this all pans out. We'll see if people's rage towards Epic Games and their store is enough to keep them from their exclusive games for 6 months to a year. Borderlands 3 launch on PC is going to be so fucking interesting. That's when everybody who's mad at Epic is going to have to put their money where their mouth is. Will the people who are so vocal about how shit Epic is actually stick to their guns and not go install this application? Because again, there's really not a whole lot of friction at the end of the day, right? You just got to install another launcher and that's it. So when push comes to shove, will you just shrug your shoulders and be like, it's one extra click? Or will you stick to your guns and be like, I will wait the year, I will wait the 6 months, I do not care? Or will you just pirate it? Will we see a huge spike in Borderlands 3 piracy? I think probably. I think that seems like the most logical choice. That's kind of the whole thing. We're seeing that same problem with all these streaming services for watching TV and movies and stuff. Everyone's trying to get in on the game now, that the most convenient thing to do is to just steal it all. That would be interesting, right? Game piracy take a huge jump because this whole Epic versus Steam debacle makes getting games legally too much of a pain in the ass. People just don't like it anymore. Regardless of what side of the fence you are, whether you're an Epic supporter or an Epic detractor, the narrative that's going to be coming out of this is going to be really interesting. Get your popcorn ready, I suppose. That's all I got for this one. Patreon.com/polystation2 if you want to support my rantings about video games. I also made a video game, Izumi and the Vertical Slice. It is on Newgrounds. People liked it on Newgrounds. Pretty fucking sick. Got front page, got featured. I don't know if it's that great. It's a little demo. Go check it out if you want to. If you want to give me a buck to support what I do, that'd be awesome. If not, support somebody. There's a ton of creators out there who deserve some money. Instead of paying for microtransactions in an EA game, take that dollar, give it to a creator, make their month. Be the games you want to see, and I'll talk to you again real soon.